This is the Star News Brief. I'm Joely Regi. President Uhuru Kenyatta will deliver the 2020 State of the Nation Address on Thursday at a joint sitting of Parliament. The president will be focusing a lot on the fight against corruption after he received a report on the same from the Director of Public Prosecutions on Monday. Other than the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic, the proposed amendments to the Constitution will also feature in the president's speech, as will the quest for electoral reforms. Kenyans will also be keen to hear what the president will have to say about the Big Four agenda, which appears to have taken a backseat as his administration tackles the pandemic and focuses on the Building Bridges initiative. Get a copy of The Star by subscribing to our e-paper for only 10 shillings by dialing *550*#. Embattled Nairobi Governor Mike Sonko's latest barrage of attacks directed at President Uhuru Kenyatta has lifted the lid on behind-the-scenes political battles to control the capital. Sonko has been relegated to the periphery in the management of the county following his arrest and prosecution over graft charges and signing away of key county functions to the national government. The flamboyant county boss now sees Uhuru as the architect of his woes that have seen him reduced to a mere figurehead without a budget to control. But without mentioning anyone, Uhuru on Tuesday urged leaders to stop politics and focus on development. There is no need of going around making noise instead of bringing development to Kenyans, he said.
Hatutaki tuwe na vita kila siku ambaye inakuwa politicized for nothing. Vita ambaye haina mbele ama haina nyuma. Tutafute njia ambao wa Kenya wataweza kufanya biashara zao kwa njia rahisi bila kusumbuliwa.
The new Nairobi commuter rail service will now serve 3 million people in a month, up from 1.2 million people in the same period. President Uhuru Kenyatta on Tuesday launched the 1.2 billion shilling project that is expected to help ease traffic congestion in the city. The rehabilitation and modernization of the Nairobi commuter rail began last year in October, and it's premised on a rail master plan, which included rehabilitating existing infrastructure and constructing new stations. The Nairobi Central Station will serve as the nerve center of operations, connecting to 10 stations in satellite towns, including newly built stations in Donholm and Pipeline. On average, the system will be transporting 30,000 to 40,000 Kenyans on a daily basis. To beat traffic, the journey via the commuter rail system will not take more than an hour to and from the central business district. Kenya loses one child due to pneumonia every hour and approximately 9,000 every year, a data report from the Health Ministry shows. The disease is a leading infectious killer among children below 5 and accounts for 15% of all deaths. As Kenya joins the rest of the world in marking the World Pneumonia Day on Wednesday, calls have been renewed to ensure early care-seeking behavior among Kenyans, with data showing that only 67% of children with the disease are taken to a health facility for care and treatment. The report states that while Kenya has made significant progress in reducing under 5 children's deaths since 1990, it is estimated that 60,000 children under the age of 5 died due to the disease in 2018 alone. Members of county assemblies now want the Building Bridges initiative amended to propose that they qualify to be appointed to county executive committees. They want a proposal similar to that allowing the president to appoint MPs to cabinet included in the provisions of the constitution on who governors can appoint. The ward reps also want the BBI to repeal a law passed in 2012 but suspended that requires that MCAs must be degree holders. Similarly, governors want a provision requiring that they select deputies of opposite gender deleted from the BBI proposals. The governors and MCAs are expected to meet President Uhuru Kenyatta and ODM leader Raila Odinga today over the proposals. Curriculum experts are scratching their heads in search of the best approach to save learners from repeating class upon reopening in January. The unique circumstances will require unique solutions for schools to catch up with the lost time occasioned by the shutdown of learning institutions during the 8-month shutdown. The Kenya Institute of Curriculum Development is legally supposed to control when and how the syllabus should be taught. Curriculum experts at the KICD will advise the Education Ministry on how the reorganization of the school calendar could be approached. Earlier suggestion by a section of stakeholders to cut down on some teachable content topics, especially in primary school, as a catch-up measure has been thrown off the table. Get a copy of The Star by subscribing to our e-paper for only 10 shillings by dialing *550*#. You can also get more on The Star website.